The opinions expressed on this program are those of the host or guests and should not be interpreted as statement of fact. Independent fact-checking and corrections are encouraged.
Can we get a cup of coffee in here, please?
Oh boy.
Damn good coffee and hot.
My dog is your mind's best friend.
Wake up, America. You've got a dog that needs walking. That's right, sunshine. Just put on a big pot of strong coffee and get ready to type your little hate mail with your opinions about kumbaya and flat earth insanity. Stand-up comedy? You want stand-up comedy? Well, we've got sit-down comedy.
No, we actually might have a stand-up
with
comedian.
A dog. You make me laugh.
I don't know anything about her. I gotta get that guy to do a new voice over. I like his voice.
You make me laugh.
I don't. If I can make you laugh, that will be nice. Make you laugh. Fontaine will make you laugh. Even if someone cute will make you laugh. As far as I'm going to go with that, by the way. Good morning, folks. It is Monday, April Fools. That's the show for you today. Bye for now. Yeah, I hope your Easter weekend went good. Easter weekend, your Holy Weekend, whatever it is. I believe this is spring break week. Unfortunately, 50 million people in the United States are in for severe weather. It is tornado season in the middle of the country. So, yeah, you know what? Yesterday, my brother had 84 degrees in North Carolina. It was 50 degrees here at the same time. Big difference. 34 degrees. Is difference between here in North Carolina. It's that time of year where you have warm and cold, and warm and cold get together. They don't like each other. Anyway, so Friday night, I had a Friday night, a Good Friday restaurant gig. And I'm thinking, nobody's going to show up for that. So on the way there, I smoked a big fat joint and was... It was sativa, so it wasn't a sleepy. It was a buzzy kind of high, but I was pretty stoned when I got there. And the place was empty. And I knew, I was like, that was, you know, verified my belief that nobody was coming out tonight. It's, you know, it's going to be empty. And we were playing with a sub drummer and a keyboard player that hadn't played with us in 5 or 6 years, who was just sitting in for the night. And so I wanted to get a little loose. But then when nobody was there, I said, you know what? Brought my can of gummies with me. And I ate 40 milligrams of gummies. And thinking, you know, nobody's... And then like 50 or 60 people came in. And then people kept coming in all night. And the place packed out. And I was like getting a little paranoid. Because I was too stoned to play, but I wasn't, and it was a very fun night. But that was the sum total of anything even remotely worth talking about on my weekend. It was a pretty laid back Easter weekend. I just considered the idea that it was my 65th Easter Sunday. You know, and whether you're religious or not, just the fact that. When you consider, because it's something that happens every year, you feel like maybe you've had more Easter Sundays than that. But then I, you know, started to reflect on people like my brother-in-law, who only got 59 Easter Sundays total in his life. He didn't get to his 60th. Not a lot of days. And life is short. That's the message here, folks. Life is short. Make the most of it. Have some good times. Have some fun. Make your life count for something. Here's the deal now. I've been, you know me. I'm on Twitter a lot. I'm on Twitter a lot. And I listen to these people. These people. These, from Alex Jones, who is the Mac Daddy of conspiracy theorists, to Joe Rogan, to RFQ. And it just occurred to me that what if all these conspiracy theories are the conspiracy? It's just, there's no deep state. There's Alex Jones and RFQ and Joe Rogan and the like. And all they do is get up every morning and look for something to sow fear and make you anxious and panicky and thinking, because every fucking day they have a new, the world is coming to an end, or how terrible things are, we're on the edge of nuclear war, chronic disease. Not that, you know, you should stick your head in the sand, but the fact that there are evil Illuminati, Freemasons, Bilderberg groups, all these crazy people out there, Rothschild, they're all conspiring together. Well, they're pretty fucking lame. If they're working on the end of the world, the depopulation of the planet, they're working on a depopulation of the planet, they're not very good at it. Because you would think it's not that hard to do. Really not that hard to do if you're serious about doing it. Anyway, so I have a new t-shirt for sale. I'm doing the Alex Jones thing here myself. I'm grifting. It's not available yet because it's still in review, because Spreadshop has a copyright review on it. It's a picture of me that I took of myself, and all it says, what if. Let me read you what it says, because it's not that hard of a sentence. I should be able to remember it, but I can't. What if all conspiracy theories are just misinformation designed to make you paranoid? What if? Because we are on the edge of paranoia. And my big conspiracy theory now is that the conspiracy theories are the conspiracy theories. But I would love, now, there is one person who reached out to me to join the Illuminati from Instagram years ago. And I just thought, this guy's just a freak, a weirdo. But somebody I know said they were getting requests from the Illuminati a lot. I want to have somebody, if somebody who has the balls to show his face, an Illuminati or a Bilderberg group guy, or, you know, somebody who's planning on destruction or taking over humanity, or I don't know. I want one of those people to come on the show. Show your face. Let's talk about your little clubhouse that you got going on there. Anyway, we have a comedian scheduled for today. Comedian Lady Nicole, who is out of Washington, D.C., and I don't know anything else about her. Another one of these guests that I couldn't even find anything. I found a Facebook page, but nothing about comedy. So we'll see how that goes. Could be a big April Fool's joke on me. Lastly, before I bring the gentleman in, and I use the term gentleman very loosely, obviously, Nicole Shanahan. RFQ is touting her as a AI expert. And she gave the speech, the speech she gave when he announced her for VP. And he was playing some clips of it. And she's talking about using AI to solve the chronic disease problem. And AI is going to be able to solve this the problem of chronic disease rather quickly. Now, I use AI for a lot of things. I've been dabbling in it for years, actually. It can't be trusted. And RFQ will be one of the first people who tells you it can't be trusted. For accuracy and safety, making sure everything needs to be fact-checked. If you buy any AI apps, they tell you right on, accuracy could be a problem. Fact-check it. Editing is going to be involved. You might need to review and adjust your prompts as needed. Well, there's no more place where accuracy is important than medicine and dealing with chronic disease. So this idea that AI is going to be trusted to solve the chronic disease problem, it's going to, if you're going to use it for that and just accept and trust it to come up with cures for, say, cancer, it's just going to make things worse. Now, if she's claiming to be an AI expert, anybody who's dabbled in AI at all knows how inaccurate results can be with that stuff. Because AI is unable to discern truth, to fact check, it goes out to a database and finds data and accepts everything as true. No matter what, it doesn't have the ability yet to question, balance and judge. And that's going to be a big problem as we move forward. So that's one of the things I want to talk to today about the esteemed, I don't know. What do we call you? We call you academics. That's what we have on this program. The academic of Stephen's sitcom work is where he's going to be obnoxious. We can't have Dolly Parton on this thing for an entire show. I'm just telling you that. I'm going to bounce that bitch right out of here.
You sexist bastard.
All right, it's already annoying.
Mom, is that you?
Yes.
Oh, never mind.
So you went out and bought a blow-up doll.
First of all, I'm not a blow-up doll. Second of all, I'm just here to promote my new dating site, Silicon Singles.
All right, promote and get away and let GD back in the room. How about that?
Okay. I see these hands. I can do a lot of things with these hands, but one of them is not operate a mouse.
I need medicine today.
Me too. Oh,
I like your room there, Stephen. You go back and play that grand piano. Give me a little whole lot of shaking going on.
I've seen that room before. I know a lot of men who have that room.
All right. Is Dolly ready to leave yet? She's already anytime. Making me angry.
All you got to do is take me out because I can't use my mouse.
Okay. Get the fuck off.
You can smell the sex on the doll. That's the problem.
It smells a lot like GD. Shame.
Now,
loneliness. Nothing.
He bought a blow-up doll for a bit, but I hope he went to Tracy's dog to get that blow-up doll. But it must have been pretty embarrassing. Like, how do you explain that to the clerk? I'm just buying this for a comedy bit.
He's probably like, yeah, I've heard that 1,000 times.
Yeah, right. Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Everyone gets lonely, I guess.
Yeah, yeah. What the fuck? Are you guys are you with me on this AI thing that asking it to fix humanity's medical situations, at least in the short term, is it's a science fiction movie ready to happen? As a science fiction horror movie ready to happen?
Man, I'm so conflicted on that because the one side of me who really loves and appreciates technology and what it's allowing people like me to do, right? Medically speaking, I think having an algorithm, that's for you, Ron, that can figure out how the body works and try to figure out and pinpoint issues, if that can be done in a fraction of the time due to AI, great. But I think when it comes to fixing anything bigger than that, I mean, its solution is going to be destroy humanity. Duh.
Yeah, I'm not.
That's
against,
how we fix it.
I'm not. Hear me clearly. I'm not against using all the technology that we have in medicine.
Right.
But thinking that it's going to do, because it's like, listen, like a video that comes up and claims G.D. Fenderson is alienating people with his music on a big time concert stage level. Like, that's AI. That's what it, you know, where did it get that information from? I asked it to do a thing on Mind Dog. I just gave it, give me a short about Mind Dog. And it came up with, I think people think I'm a rock star. Some people think I'm a great comedian. Other people think I'm a deep state spy or something. I didn't tell it any of that. It went out and found, I guess, conversations and video that it just well, must be true. Like, so, you know, you don't want that with the disease thing. That, you know, you can go out and find any information about, like, COVID, cancer, or anything, and just read it and think, oh, okay, that's all true. I'm going to apply that now. It's dangerous.
Yeah, this AI is powered by Wikipedia. That's a problem.
Yeah, yeah.
But did you see that video I dropped in the email?
I did. I can't share that because it's on Instagram. If you want to share that, we could do it.
I have it up on YouTube. I did put it there. I can send you that link or whatever.
You can't just share it. Don't you have the video right there that you can share that present?
Yeah, I can share it. I could do that too.
Ooh, movie time!
It's about cults. And just so you're aware, his isn't the same one that you saw that I put up, because I did a thing about the five most dangerous cults. And YouTube sent me a letter this morning saying they have age restricted that, so that if you're not signed in as and verified as over 18, they won't allow you to see it at all, which I thought was really weird. It was not like. Was not promoting anything. It was not really. I was telling the story of Jonestown, Waco, Heaven's Gate, Manson family, and the Son of Sam cult.
You left out the Trump cult. The cult.
They have not committed mass suicide or mass murder yet. Yet.
Well, the idea is you left them out, and now they won't think about it. They need to be encouraged.
Well, who is good morning, Sammy Magwelly, do we know Sammy?
Yeah, no.
No. All right. Did you
but
are
all
you ready?
Welcomed. All
are
welcome.
You ready to share that cult movie?
Yep. Let's do it.
All right. Let's age restrict everybody. If you're under 18, get out of the room.
Yes. All right.
So you're looking for buttons to push? Steven, are you back in the hospital again? I thought you were home.
I'm going home today at noon.
Oh, all right. Well, I'm going to play the movie right now. Here all we right. go.
Ever pondered how Easter, a festival synonymous with bunnies, eggs, and pastel colors, might transform under the influence of satanic cults? It might surprise you that soft pretzels play a significant role, and Easter hunts are conspicuously absent. Today, we delve into the unusual and intriguing ways these enigmatic groups celebrate this springtime holiday. Picture a soft pretzel, its characteristic twist, the crunchy salt sprinkled on top, the warm, doughy interior. Now, imagine it not as a snack at a baseball game, but as a symbol of an alternative Easter celebration. Satanic cults have adopted this unlikely food item as their Easter tradition, but why a pretzel? The answer lies in the pretzel's twist. It symbolizes the eternal cycle of life and death, a concept revered by satanic cults. As they bite into the soft pretzel, they acknowledge the unending cycle of existence, a poignant moment of reflection amidst the festivities. But a satanic Easter isn't just about soft pretzels, it's also about what's absent. Easter hunts, a joyous tradition for many, are notably missing from these unusual celebrations. Instead of searching for painted eggs in the backyard, satanic cults focus on a darker kind of search. They seek a symbolic sacrifice, a representation of the death and rebirth cycle that the pretzel signifies. Remember, these sacrifices are often symbolic, allowing the cult members to connect deeply with their beliefs and traditions. Now let's add another twist to this tale. Imagine a hot dog cooked over open flames encased in a pretzel coating. This unique dish is a part of the satanic Easter tradition as well. The hot dog symbolizes the flesh, the pretzel coating the eternal cycle, and the flame, the purifying force. It's a complex yet fascinating symbol that brings together the key tenets of their belief system. So, what have we learned? Satanic cults celebrate Easter in a way that might seem unusual to most of us. Soft pretzels and the absence of Easter hunts are two key elements of their traditions. They embrace symbols of life, death, and rebirth, and these symbols are deeply woven into their celebrations. Whether it's the eternal twist of a pretzel or the symbolic sacrifice, these traditions reflect their unique interpretation of Easter. In conclusion, Easter for satanic cults is a time of reflection, a celebration of the eternal cycle, and a reaffirmation of their beliefs. It's a fascinating divergence from the mainstream, a testament to the diverse ways in which people, regardless of their beliefs, can interpret and celebrate the same festival. So next time you bite into a soft pretzel, remember the unusual, intriguing, and diverse ways in which this humble snack is celebrated around the world.
Next time you bite into a pretzel. Oh, wait, I just took him out. I went to take the movie.
I think that Ron has started there would be like a rush on Annie's pretzels by MAGA people who just want to shoot the place up, just like they did the pizza place when they thought that Hillary was running a pedophile ring at the bottom of a pizza place that didn't even have a basement.
It feels like the April Fools is off to a kicking start here.
Why is it
gonna
kick?
I don't know. Is any of that real? I mean, this kind of highlights what my concerns about using for medicine. First of all, our guest who was supposed to be here 7 minutes ago is not here. But so maybe that's an April Fool's joke. Anyway, but is any of that shit real, or is that just like from
did they go out to
the Onion and find an article and assume it was all real?
I just used that AI tool. I wrote most of that script and. There it is.
Wow. Pretzels. Now, Easter eggs is a whole other paganistic type of ritual anyway. Bunnies don't lay eggs. You can eat all those real chocolate eggs that your bunny leaves.
Cadbury commercial. I know the bunnies can lay.
No, go ahead. Follow a bunny around. Every chocolate egg that comes out of it, you just gobble it down.
You don't eat all of them. You just eat the ones that he lays that are wrapped in foil.
Wow.
If you eat the ones that aren't wrapped in foil, you're asking for all kinds of trouble.
Right.
Cadbury eggs. Cadbury eggs are just training to be in Bukkake films. That's all they are. You pull them apart. Mm-hmm.
I got a little satanic pretzel stuck.
They use their pretzels and the eggs at Bohemian Grove, and that's how they summon Satan, and they feed them goodies on Easter.
I definitely don't want to promote Satanism, but if we have any Satanists in the audience who know about the pretzel ritual, please send let me know. I'll send you a link and come on and join and explain to us your fascination with a salty, soft delight.
The thing, Matt, you say you don't want to promote Satan, but if Satan deserves a promotion, are you going to deny him the promotion?
Or
are you
just going to say Satan? I said Satanism.
Okay, if they deserve a promotion, are you going to deny them the promotion because of their religion? Or you going to pick some promote some Christian over top of it?
Yeah,
that's what I want to know. It's
I am. All right.
Was it the EEOC?
Devil's Tongue Pretzels, $8.99. let me see. Why can't you consecrate a pretzel? Step back, Satan. Why can't you consecrate a pretzel? So
it's not consummate.
No, it says consecrate.
Okay.
Discovering religious significance of pretzels. Apparently, it found a lot of shit on the internet about this. 1970 movement to reclaim pretzels for God. Reclaim pretzels for God. This is all just so fucking bizarre. I can't. What have we learned here today? Well, we've learned you should not take hallucinogens on a Monday morning after a long weekend.
That's fair.
We have learned that there are rabbit holes that even I didn't even know existed, but thank you, Ron, for pointing us the way.
Now, what was the prompt you put in there? Do you remember the prompt you gave it to create that video?
I put in a decent amount of stuff in there about, they don't do the hunts anymore and the whole thing about the pretzel. So
you knew about the pretzels.
Yeah, I wrote most of that in there and then let the AI go to work, and that's what it turned out on me.
So, are you a Satanist? Have you dabbled in Satanism? How do you know about the pretzel thing?
No, the pretzel, it's all made up. It's all made up. So, there's some of the things that Satanists talk about, like their rules, they're actually pretty good.
we've been hanging out with a bunch of Satanists, and we still. And how come you're not inviting them to the York Doghouse?
Just like one of their core principles is, they call people ignorant instead of just stupid at first, because they say if you just say someone's stupid, it just means they haven't been taught or they. They haven't learned anything. No one's been able to show it to them. So they feel most people are ignorant to their cause or whatever, but they can be taught. And I kind of like that. It's like, that kind of makes sense. But other than that, I don't care.
I think some people are willfully ignorant. And if you're willfully ignorant, I think you deserve to be called stupid. That's my...
That's fair.
Yeah.
I thought stupid meant you couldn't learn, and ignorant just meant you haven't learned or won't learn.
I think that's correct. That's a correct. Ignorant means you ignore.
Right.
Yeah. You willfully.
You ignore ants, which is why, and uncles. Well, that's ignorant uncle, but yeah, ignorant ants.
Wow.
Ignorance.
A lot to think about already here today.
The pretzel and the hot dog is something to consider. I'm telling you.
I've never heard of a pretzel hot dog. A hot dog in a pretzel.
The bun. The bun is made of pretzel.
Never heard of that. Uh-oh. Ron is sacrificing the cat.
Yeah. Yeah, I think Annie Ann's has them. You can get them, and whoever else sells that shit.
With all the you're Satan pointing in politics today, why hasn't anybody brought up the pretzel people and point at pretzel companies? Because this weekend, I don't know if you're aware of this, you probably are, that by the way, yesterday was Trans Visibility Day, Trans Person Visibility Day. I didn't see one trans person. There's probably not that many of them, to be honest with you. I mean, the people are panicking. But they're calling Biden Satan, a Satanist, for having that on Easter Sunday. Now, here's the thing. Biden did not initiate that. George W. Bush, Congress passed the Trans Visibility Day in 2008. Bush signed it into law. It was first recognized in 2009 in Obama's first year as president. But it's since 2009, it's always been March 31st. But apparently they just found out about it and was blaming Biden about it for this weekend, calling him Satanist. How dare you have Trans Visibility Day on Easter, the most holy day in the Christian calendar? You must be a Satanist. And then the other side's calling Trump the Antichrist. So there's a lot of Satan pointing around, but nobody's pointing at the pretzel companies and the mall, where they have lunch in the mall there, that
food court.
Yeah, the food court. Nobody's pointing at that.
It's all a conspiracy. It's all a conspiracy, man. There's pretzels and the hot dogs. Yeah.
New York City is filled with pretzel vendors on the streets.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got to watch out. I mean, like I said, the pretzel encompasses everything. And The hot dog, if you think about it, is just a collection of different meats put together, or ends or scraps to make a meat.
Yeah.
Now the pretzel is just the pretzels that are twisted. That are satanic, right? Not the straight pretzels or the knotted pretzels. The
pretzel sticks balls. Should be fine. Yeah.
Right, pretzel sticks, right?
Should be because okay. Those pretzels are straight. They're fine.
Right, they're straight. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's the curve, it's the one.
It's the twist.
It's straight.
The fuckable ones. It's the ones that have like this, that you have like three holes, or the Holy Trinity that you have to worry out for.
All hail pretzels.
I'm so confused. Now,
I hate it here.
Pretzels are German, right? Or Bavarian, no. Right? Or no, some kind of Bavarian.
Bavarian.
I thought they were food court.
The answer I found is Germany.
They're German.
German. Yeah. So I mean, that kind of ties into the whole Nazi. Like, listen, I have German blood in me. I'm not like, if you're a German person, please don't be offended to this. But. there is kind of a relationship between Nazism and Satanism, I think, right? So I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't have pretzels. I have a big bag of pretzels in the closet there. Should I go throw them out? Should I burn my Beatle records? What should I do?
I don't know, but I know like someone listening to this right now or watching this, they're like, oh my God, this whole pretzel conspiracy is
right. We're gonna get somebody hurt. Some pretzel vendor is gonna get assaulted. And
Auntie Anne's gonna end up kidnapped.
No, I don't think the Nazis were Satanists per se. I think they took regular occult symbols and twisted them around. So like the swastika, they screwed around with the many of the symbols that they used. But I'm not even sure it was Hitler who started all that crap. In the Nazis, because there were a bunch of other members of the Nazi party that were really, really into the occult. Hitler was just like, we're along for the ride. He was like a late bloomer.
Right. He was like you. He was buying sex toys for jokes.
Technically, I'm not buying sex toys for jokes. I'm buying them for a show.
all to be dedicated. Or donated to the Salvation Army afterwards, right?
No, if the show goes well, it'll be used for another show.
Have you used that dolly as intended?
You mean for podcasting? I used her yesterday.
That's not what I'm talking about. The intended use of the manufacturer, where it says, "Where did it come with instructions?"
You know, the instructions are so fucking tiny. It's a sheet like this. It's a sheet. I'm not exaggerating. The sheet is like this long, which is about 30 inches. It's about this wide. And the print is like whatever the smallest font is on the computer. I think they shrank that. I think it's like a two-point font.
Now, did you go into a local shop to buy it or did you buy it online? Please tell me.
No, I went into a shop.
Yeah, you got to meet your neighbors.
Right, I went into a shop.
You could have bought it from Tracy's dog and at least, I don't know, made the show look good.
Because I need to, because these sex toys are not being used like as advertised. They're being used for different things. And I need to know that I can adapt them for what I need them to.
You tried it out in the store?
Well, yes and no. I didn't open the package, but I did check to see if they would serve the purposes.
It looks like they're chopping Steven's foot off right now as we're speaking. Like he's looking like anguished.
But now, and I can't remember why I bought them.
Just see a foot go over his shoulder.
I got this one here.
What the? What is that you just showed us?
It's a
penis pump.
This is a 7-inch.
Penis pump.
No, this isn't a pump. This is there's the back end of this is a suction cup. So you can actually attach it to a wall or something, like in a shower, I guess.
Uh-huh.
It's just for his ass. Yep. All right.
For the people on the radio, listening to us on the radio, please concentrate on the road. What he was showing was like what looked like a dildo, but it has a suction cup on it that you apply to the wall so you can ride the right the wall in your house, I guess.
Yeah, these are shot glasses.
No, I'm not doing a shot out of that. Again, for the people on the radio, he's selling up what looks like a cock and balls with looks like my cock after if they drilled out the hole in the when I was 9 years old with a huge jewel.
I'm sorry if I triggered you, man. I am so sorry.
This has been a very traumatic morning already. April Fools, people.
This is
show and tell from GD's trip. he took a field trip to the local sex toy show, and he's giving us a show and tell.
Well, let me just check. I think, yeah, this is also a 7-inch one.
And it's got a section. It has a suction cup
also.
But so why'd you buy two of the same thing? Is it red and blue? One for colors. Democrats, one for Republicans.
Different colors.
So when you got home, did your wife look at that? And go, what do you have planned for tonight?
Really?
Well, the thing is, I didn't tell my wife about them simply because, again, I was using them. They're not done yet. I'm not done working with them. They are not in their final stage.
So now it's going to look worse when she opens up a closet and just finds this pile of dildos or whatever else you have.
I mean, she does know about them. Ron, you've heard me say this on stage like probably 100 times already. I don't have any secrets from my wife. I just have shit I don't tell her.
Right. That's why I was like, can I get the last one just so I can take pictures?
Give him the last one.
Yeah, give him the last one, anally.
Last rites? Did he ask for last rites? Is that what he just asked for?
Give him the last one.
Can I get last rites over here?
Bring him a pretzel.
Pretzel! Now, one time at Shea Stadium, back when there was a Shea Stadium, my brother and I were like in the upper deck or something, and somebody threw a pretzel out to the left, thinking about this. Tim, what was his? The Expos, I can't remember his last name.
Tim Horton?
No. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Little Rock was his nickname. He was playing left field, and I was concerned that he was going to run and trip on the pretzel and hurt himself. So I started yelling, pretzel, pretzel, and then the whole section where we were, we started yelling pretzel, pretzel, and then like that whole side of Shea Stadium was yelling pretzel, and he's looking up like, what the fuck? I've heard a lot of things in baseball stadiums. What the hell are you people yelling? And everybody was yelling pretzel, pretzel. Now looking back, he might have thought there was a satanic ritual going on in the left field
stand. Not then, but he does now because he's watching the show right now.
Right.
And he's glad he got out of there with his life.
You all right, Steve?
Yes, sir.
You don't look all right. You look anguished. You look like you were calling for last rites there.
No, sir.
The doctor is not going to let him out.
Are they going to let you out? Because if they're not going to let you out, I'll come there. I'll straighten things out for you. I will come there and make things right with these people.
It's like a prison break.
Yeah.
Nope. I'm leaving around noon. So.
Do you have a show tonight?
Yes.
I thought I saw on your calendar that you had an April Fool's show.
I do.
Or is that just a prank?
Nope, that's a real one.
Hi, nurse.
They said hello.
Oh, hi. I'm sorry.
Whoa, we have a talking nurse.
This one's nice. This one's cool.
You shouldn't say that out loud because that implies the other ones aren't nice and aren't cool.
Some of them weren't nice and some of them weren't cool.
Yeah, but you're implying. Actually, now you're not implying it anymore. It's, now you're just
it's coming directly
you
out.
You were
saying
implying it
directly.
You're just saying it.
Yeah. Well, so they have to let you out because this is show business, and the show must go on.
It has to.
So,
or they do the show there.
Yeah. No, it's just so confusing, this whole pretzel thing. Like, so pretzels are not good. You can't enjoy a pretzel if you're If you're a good person at all, just get rid of your pretzels and boycott pretzels altogether.
Are you kidding? Look at how popular Chick-fil-A is, and they are much worse than pretzels.
Why? What's wrong? I know there was controversy about them, but what was it?
Not the workers. It's the policies of the people who are the CEOs and stuff like that. They pretty much have, let's just say, anti-gay and anti-trans, your basic fundamentalist Christian philosophy.
And they've supported like gay conversion therapy, like those groups and shit.
Just about to say that. Yep.
Gay conversion therapy. Yeah. Pray away the gay. That kind of
yes.
Yeah. Electroshock.
Sometimes it's pray away. Sometimes you beat it away. Sometimes depends on.
There's rumors that all of the above happens at some of those camps. So
yeah, they smother it away. They drown it away. They baptize it away.
I'd say I'm straight too if you waterboarded me.
Yeah.
Jeez. Now,
did any of you guys see a trans person yesterday?
I know many, 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 many trans people.
But did you? Because yesterday was Visibility Day. Did you see them?
I didn't leave my house.
Didn't make themselves visible to you.
If any of the staff that came in were, they are doing a fantastic job.
Now, my biggest issue with trans with men that are transitioning from male to female. Okay, my biggest issue is like quite often they're like midway, they haven't finished the transition, but they've started putting on women's makeup, but without any kind of education. And so quite often I'm not staring at them because they're mid trans. I'm staring at them because Sherman Williams will have a fucking field day with the color palettes on their faces.
Yeah.
And they should go to a drag party or Avon party or to learn to put on makeup properly to accent, you know.
Just look at magazine covers.
So do you hear that, yeah. LGBTQ community? GD wants you prettier.
Yes.
That's right.
I'm not saying that I care that you're pretty or not. I'm saying if you don't want people to stare at you, don't make your face look like a clown fucked it. Okay?
Art is all subjective.
No, art is not it's not subjective.
Or leave a sex shop with a pile of dildos claiming it's for a bit.
Uh-oh. I'm getting yelled at.
Well, I can prove they're for a bit because I put them on my business card and it's going to be on my taxes. So it's going to be like on my taxes. Six dildos.
The IRS agent that goes through your stuff is going to be like, this man has fun.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's going to be on my taxes. It's a deduction because I'm using it specifically for shows. So, and I put it on my business card.
This is also very confusing on April Fool's Monday.
I can't use them for personal pleasure if I wanted to because I'd be crossing the line between tax and non-tax or taxable deduction and non-taxable deduction.
I don't know that they would be able to discern the difference. It's kind of like AI and the web believing everything that comes its way.
Now they can probably tell by smell, though.
Right, that's what I'm saying. If they just smell like customers, if they just smell like people at a comedy show, it's business. But if they smell like me and my wife, that's pleasure. That's personal.
Well, the new comedy smell.
It smells like pretzels.
If it smells like comedy, it's business.
We need to release a candle line. One that smells like bean flicking cookies. One that smells like clown fucked it. Fresh pretzels and pile of dildos. Oh, and GD and his wife, passion fruit.
Now, I think if I'm... I just want to make sure I got this right. Because what day was it? Friday, Willie sent me. Ordered the power cord on Amazon. Should be here tomorrow. So, sorry for the disruption, which I was kind of expecting he might be here today. But apparently he's on vacation. I think he's in the Salt Lake City airport for a few weeks. Got a few weeks stay at the airport there. you know, whatever. I'm not sure Willie's ever coming back. I don't know what's going on with him. I don't see him online. Like, generally, every day he would be posting from the minute he woke up to the minute he fell asleep at night, posting memes of positivity. Haven't seen him doing any of that.
He's posted the last couple of days.
Oh, you have? I haven't seen him. Mm-hmm. All right.
Yep, Willie's still alive and semi-kicking.
Now you're going to...
Thank you.
Tell us to stop interrupting my show.
She said she's going to castrate me if you yell at her again. So
get your enema and get it over with.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought that was a water bottle.
It's the enema.
The enema.
Yeah. You're going to perform with Willie in Sioux City, Iowa. You're flying there, right?
Correct.
Is he flying there?
You know, I don't know. but I do know that I'm flying in. I'm getting there at like midnight, so I'm just gonna stay.
Yeah, I'm not concerned about you. You're not gonna lose anything. If Willie is flying, I'm concerned he might lose something vital to his existence.
I'll be with him from the time he gets there till the time I fly out, so I'll make sure he keeps track of everything.
Notebooks.
Oh, right.
Power cords.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Clothes. Toothbrush. You know, whatever. Watch
next week.
His teeth. He might lose his teeth.
That's true. Because they're not attached.
Yeah. keep an eye on him. This is a concern. He might end up staying at that airport and not going to this. He has a kind of airport fetish. So he might not even go to the comedy club. He might want to just do the show straight at the airport.
Zoom live from the airport.
And Stephen, if he offers to give you sexual favors, have him take his teeth out first, just so you know.
Yeah.
You know, that's my question to anyone that offers right off the top, is your teeth come out? So
his does.
Great.
His do.
Now, I'm concerned that our guest is not here because she sent me a thing. She got it. She was all excited about it just last night. I mean, late last night I got. So she was on board with it as of last night.
Right.
No shows are really confusing the hell out of me.
Yeah, it's super weird. I mean.
We got love from India. Now, India, do you have pretzels over there? Yeah. Do you put mustard on your pretzels? This is the question.
I do.
Actually, it's an important question.
the Sikhs have pretzels. The Hindus don't. It's the other way around. Hindus have pretzels. Sikhs do not. Sikhs do not have pretzels.
Wow. So now the Steely Dan album, Pretzel Logic.
Yes.
Satanic?
I would think so, especially Steely Dan.
Steely Dan. I got to look up the lyrics. Because I feel like I might have been being indoctrinated my whole life and not really grasped this whole pretzel connection.
That's the deep state for you.
That is the deep state. Now, these, I'm thinking from your statement there, that the deep state, that you think I'm off base with this whole conspiracy theories are the big conspiracy. The idea that people are just putting up stuff to make us panic and paranoid and scared all the time is the great conspiracy, that all the other conspiracies are just made up bullshit to make you anxious and worried all the time. Yes or no? Am I wrong? Am I right?
Yeah.
I think you're...
Yeah.
I could get, it does make sense because, you know, now, you know, everyone's got a voice. So it's so easy to, you know, your crazy uncle that no one ever knew, except maybe the couple crazy guys down at the bar. Now he's got a platform. So it's horrible.
Right. Well, so RFQ was on Twitter last night with another one. He's got so many of these conspiracy theories, but he was just talking about, you know, government, you know, involvement in medicine and all this stuff. And I was like, so basically as president, what you're going to do every day as president is tweet out conspiracy shit. It's like, we've already had that. And this is the problem in America. We're all like, we're all like freaking out because we had 4 years of a president who just spent all day and night on Twitter and Facebook and every other place tweeting out conspiracy theories. I think the if we can say anything positive about Biden, he doesn't talk a lot. He doesn't tweet a lot. He
well, it's hard to do that when you can't remember what you're going to say.
Well, he's actually he's battling a stutter, so you don't want to battle. It's difficult enough battling a stutter, but then if you're taking, let's say, using keys that could have sticky keys, which we know is a thing, sticky keys is a thing, you're taking a greater risk of stuttering on, and then it's in print. You don't want to stutter in print.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's that's pretty much why he doesn't do it.
I do enjoy, though, how the White House Twitter account trolls Donald Trump. That's pretty funny.
Yeah.
Like when he puts out there, like, I won at my golf tournament, and they just troll him. It's fucking hilarious.
Right. Now,
the Reverend won the church golf tournament 2 weeks ago, but you didn't see him bragging about it.
Yeah.
The church golf tournament?
Yeah, the Church of Les Resort, their golf tournament. You didn't hear him bragging about it.
No, did Jack Nicklaus give him the trophy?
No, Arnold Palmer's.
Is he still alive? I don't think so.
No.
No, the drinks.
The drinks are amazing.
Yeah, the drinks.
Oh. You heard about the, because Trump tweeted out last week, retweeted, people wanting to kidnap Biden. They had him in the back of a pickup truck, a dummy, an effigy, like tied up, and they were taking him to hang Joe Biden in the back of a pickup truck. And these guys have not been arrested.
It was just a painting. It's not an effigy.
It was like a decal that they put on, like a sticker.
Right, and it's 4 years old. That they did that.
This was a video from Huntington, Long Island. They were on the Long Island Expressway on Friday in the rain in two pickup trucks, one following the other in MAGA trucks, and they had a tied up Joe Biden in the back. Fuck Biden. And they were taking him, you know, supposedly to hang. Now,
Okay, so this is a new one. Oh, okay.
Yeah. This was just the other day. But these guys are in my neighborhood now. Back in the normal times when there was normalcy in the world, if you threatened, if you even joked about hanging a president, kidnapping a president, hanging him, the Secret Service, the FBI would be at your door. These guys have not even been questioned yet. Nothing. It's just like anything goes now.
The hardest part about that is that nowadays, a third of the FBI probably agree with them. So they'll like go up, knock on the door, and say like, "Hey, look, guys, technically this is illegal, but I'm not going to bust your chops about it because I got a bunch of black guys standing on the corner down the street. So just, you know, be chill. Do it, but don't post it, okay? Because otherwise, I'm going to have to come back, and it may not be me next time. It may be an actual FBI agent who believes in the law, and they may arrest you.
I feel like there might be some big news happening today. I don't want to say what it is, because if I'm wrong, then but if I don't say what it is, then and something happens, I could always say, yeah, that's what
you
I was
You and your wife are expecting another child?
I'm not saying what the news is. It might be some news today is all I'm saying.
Oh, okay.
So that when anything happens newsworthy, I could take credit for it and say, see, so
Matt's going to be a dad again.
No.
Well, speaking of Daddy Matt, did you see that another bridge in Ohio got hit by a boat?
No.
It didn't knock it over, but they shut the bridge down and everything. Yeah.
Now, Trump's little girlfriend here, Mike Shavola, says, but it's funny when a comedian holds Trump's severed head in the hand. I never said that was funny.
Yeah, no one said that.
So don't fuck yourself with that stupid comment.
Yeah, in fact, even most comedians were like, there's a difference between making a joke and making what seems like a very real threat and holding a severed head. Isn't funny.
Nobody I know thought that was funny.
I thought it was inaccurate
because if you've ever watched Trump, you know that there's not that much blood is making it to his brain. So obviously, there was way too much blood coming out of that head.
Yeah,
so
no,
that
no.
was my problem. With that was my problem with the fact
nobody, that nobody had. Yeah,
I didn't say. Back. He said, "I didn't say." You said nobody said it. Actually, most comedians were right, like got, all got, over Kathy Griffin when that shit happened. I didn't see anybody endorsing it.
Yeah,
and I think she got. Yeah. Didn't she lose her job over it?
Yeah, she did.
Yeah, yeah.
For a while, she got rehab. She gets put on shows all the time again. But
right, well,
but she lost the spot for sure.
Yeah, like the New Year's Eve thing she used to do with Anderson Cooper.
Yep.
Yeah. They replaced. Was it Anderson Cooper or the other guy?
The other
one
guy.
Of those two guys she used to do this New Year's Eve show with.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, she did a joke in poor taste. So I mean. But either way, I mean, she shouldn't be stopped from performing. I mean,
right.
We all make bad jokes. That happens.
Right. But I do think, you know what, if she's going to do that shit, the FBI should definitely go question her about it. I mean, if the Secret Service and the FBI have a job to do, and Secret Service especially, is to protect the president. And so anybody making even veiled threats, they should at least question it, pay him a visit, and make sure you're not a danger to the president, no matter if you like the president or hate the president. So, you know, there's that. But, you know, RFQ talks all the time about how he still has not gotten Secret Service protection. And I guess he has a point with that.
Yeah.
My only counter to that is your uncle
he's
and
not entitled to super, he's not entitled to it.
Yeah, he is. According what? To
not, no, you know, according, you know
what, wait, let me finish my sentence, please.
Okay.
According to the last 13 presidents, when they got or as candidates, when they got Secret Service protection, it was all well in, deeper in farther out than he is. He's 200 days from the election. He hasn't got it. If you name every single candidate or presidential candidate within the last 13 elections, they had it. Obama had it 850 days out. It's 200 days out. He still hasn't got it.
I have a question.
I'm just saying Secret Service protection is at the discretion of actually Mayorkas. It's up to him.
But right. But it's in precedent has been set that by he is well within the time that every single one in the last 13 elections have had it.
So it's a new precedent.
Did Gary Johnson get that protection in 2016?
Yes.
Did he? Okay. I wasn't sure. I didn't know. I never actually saw if he had anyone with him.
Well, he posted the chart about when everybody got it, and the closest was Jill Stein at 240 days out. But Jill Stein got.
So what's the deal then?
It's a conspiracy.
It, you know.
It kind of feels like
he
it.
Is the most likely to get. Assassinated just by the stretch of his last name.
If he was going to get shot, he'd have been shot already. We know how Kennedy luck goes. Once Kennedy's making past age 50, they don't get shot anymore. Then he just have to die another way.
They need to get him a Q-mobile just to drive him around like the Pope.
I don't know. But his father might argue against that a little bit. But
his father wasn't 50 when he got shot.
Just don't stand near him in a public place. That's all we're saying.
Just don't stand in front of or behind him. Just to the sides.
Right, but and that's my point with that. The Secret Service is his father and his uncle both had Secret Service protection. Secret Service wasn't really all that reliable in that. So, I mean, you're probably better off with your own personal private security because the Secret Service. If you count on their effectiveness with his father and his uncle, not so good.
All he has to do is stand next to Nicole Shanahan because she's got protection enough for both of them.
Reagan also was protected by a Secret Service agent. He got shot, and the Secret Service agent got killed. But we can go back, you know, to the first one. Garfield, I believe, got stabbed in the back in a post office, and he had Secret Service protection, so... You know, Teddy Roosevelt got shot while giving a speech and kept giving the speech.
But they get better. They're getting better at it all the time. They're getting better at it. They're learning. It's a learning curve. Secret Service is a learning curve.
Gerald Ford got shot at twice, but the only reason he wasn't killed was because the people were bad shots.
Vice president.
No, he was president.
And I'm saying the reason why he didn't get killed is because they thought about who his vice president was. And they say, and at the last second, somebody went, are you kidding?
They were worried about Nelson Rockefeller?
Yeah.
The one thing that's horrible about all of this is, like, no matter what you post anymore, whether it's like about some event or some little thing, some asshole wants to make it political. Like, it has some type of political meaning. I'm not sure if you see that on the music side, but for comedy and things like that.
No, everything. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, it's terrible. It's like, go someplace else with your terrible decisions or whatever you're trying to say.
Vic DiBattetto just says, gas prices during the pandemic were very low. Please raise your hand if you know why, and don't tell me stick to funny. That's a bullshit comment, and I'm just asking you to explain it seriously. I'm sure, because he gets told that every time he says anything on Twitter, is why he's saying, don't tell me to stick to comedy. He's not allowed you're not allowed to talk about things because you're in entertainment. Just stick to music, stick to comedy, stick to whatever. I think people are allowed to have opinions or get involved in conversations. Just because you're in entertainment, you don't give up your humanity or your citizenship or your right to have conversations about things.
Well, there's not a single silver, there's not a single magic bullet answer as to why prices are the way they are. Part of it is supply and demand. Part of it, you know, because at the time, well, during the COVID, during the pandemic, people were not driving as much. Okay, so they weren't going places. So the prices of gas has dropped because of that. Once they got loose and they got freaky and started driving everywhere, that's when the supply and demand changed. And also, that's when corporations realized that they could just gouge the fuck out of us, and we were not going to do anything about it. We're just going to lay back and take it. And then prices never go back to where they were before the condition that existed that they say is the reason why they had to raise the prices. They never go back to where they were. So it's a multiple of reasons. It's not just, please tell me why. Because even if I did tell you why, and you wouldn't understand it, and you wouldn't believe me anyway. But that's what it is. It's a multiple of reasons. It's not just one.
Well, I would disagree with one part of that, and that they never go back. During the Bush administration,
okay, I'll say seldom.
I remember this. Oh, yes, yeah, seldom go back.
Okay, now you can start. Now I say seldom. I just did what I accused my wife of doing. Because my wife says, you never listen. And I said, I do listen. And she goes, well, shut up and listen.
I remember distinctly during the Bush administration going to a gig, and I could not believe the gas prices were under $2 a gallon. And when I got there, I told everybody, and they were like freaking out, where? Like, you know, when was the, because it had been like 30 years since it was under $3 a gallon at that point.
And people also got spoiled because they, let's put it this way. Prices, as a general rule of thumb, go up. Okay. Prices go up over time. Wages go up over time. The thing is, what's not natural is when wages are artificially held frozen in place while prices keep going up. That's not normal. Okay. I'm old enough to remember when gas was 25 cents a gallon. Okay. 25 cents a fucking gallon.
Those Model T's must have been rough.
I could fill up my gas, my gas powered lawnmower and cut 9 lawns and make like $6, you know, and get like a whole case of sodas for $6 or whatever. So yeah, gas used to be 25 cents. Ice cream used to be a nickel. Prices go up. People adjust. If something's too expensive, just don't fucking buy it.
I want to share a video. Well, we're changing the subject matter here drastically. It's about what people will do for attention, likes, and all that kind of stuff on the internet. Now, I'm going to share a video, if I can. I want you guys to react to this.
Oh, yeah.
Now, for the people on the radio side, what we're seeing is a girl on a high-rise building hanging out just by a arm hold. She's grabbing. Now you can see her tits. So that's
what a retard. This is dumb.
There are camera people all over taking several angles of this. She's just hanging on by a handshake, kind
fuck
of.
That. Fuck that, man. My butt cheeks are quivering just watching that.
If I got any more taut, I would produce diamonds. That was ridiculous.
It's an awful, stupid thing to do. A high price to pay if something goes wrong there.
Well, obviously she's a keeper. Back. Any woman that lets you do that to her is into anal. Maybe she did that instead of anal.
She's in much more than anal.
It seemed like it was probably her idea. Like, she wanted to do that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the guy who's holding her there is putting himself in major jeopardy. If she falls, he's probably going to be...
Destroy the film. Destroy the video evidence.
No, she didn't fall.
Just saying, if she falls, destroy the video
evidence. If she falls, push the camera, guys.
There were three camera... It looked like three camera people there. It looked like somebody was trying to... Because that was weird. Now, I should play it again just for verification. But it looked... There was a angle that looked like it was from over his shoulder. But from the far side, you didn't see anybody shooting that. So I'm wondering, is this like a... Hollywood.
There was one that looks like there's one camera that he was rubbing in his mouth or strapped to his head.
I don't think that was special effects. These videos are on my TikTok all the time. These are just extreme adrenaline junkies is all they are. And they do it on purpose. They do it all over the place. It's so dumb.
So you don't see any camera person by him.
And he's holding. It looks like he's
right
holding
now. We're looking.
Mouth.
He's. It's a far shot from behind him. Now looking like directly over his shoulder. Now, where did that shot come
that
from?
That camera. He's either holding in.
It's in his mouth.
Yeah,
I think it's in his mouth or attached to his head. I can't tell which.
Yeah, that it's
in his mouth.
Oh yeah, yeah. You can see something in.
Yep,
his mouth.
It's in his mouth, and that shot is. Yeah, that's his right arm going down.
And then somebody else is hanging off the side of the building, taking a sidewise shot. Very strange. Oh, yeah. What the fuck? He's got the camera in his mouth. Now,
with a dental dam.
He's got to be pretty strong. And she's got to be pretty strong.
Yeah, it still just takes one little shit.
I couldn't imagine that what were we talking about?
Yeah. If you were going to do that in Hollywood, you would have like a string or some, you know, some kind of harness that even if you let go, she wasn't going to
fall. Tom Cruise does his shit, I mean, they can edit it and make it look like he has nothing on. Like, when he held onto the plane, he really held onto a plane.
Yeah.
Or, like,
yeah,
when
he had insurance. He had insurance.
Well, insurance, and he also had straps and everything. But yeah, the videos like that girl, though, I see those all over the place. And it is – every time it makes me sick to my stomach just because I'm like, ugh, it's too high. But it's so crazy that they do that. They even do it off of, like, cruise ships.
And the payout here is that's going to go viral. How much money are they? No names are involved, right? So they're not getting famous off it.
I don't even know how the monetization on how that works in general. I've never made a video that's gone viral. But I mean, I've heard like it depends on what it's on, right? Because like I heard TikTok used to do really good, but not anymore. I heard YouTube's the big payer now. X and YouTube.
Yeah,
are probably the two biggest.
If you can get in YouTube and their like ad program, it's like a 50-50 split. I think they do with you on ads.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go back to politics for a second.
If I was involved with a woman who did that with me, I honestly wouldn't continue to date her.
Too hot to lose, man.
There's no such thing as too big to fail, too hot to lose. There's no such thing, okay? I was engaged to a model, and when things got crazy, I had to drop her like a fucking hot potato.
Well, we almost saw her boob, so that was enticing.
Hey, you know what, man? I went from a good morning to a great morning. I missed you guys Friday, and I'm so glad to be back, and that just made it worth it. So.
Oh, you weren't here Friday? It felt like you were here.
I was not. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Did you at least send Matt a note to let him know you're not going to be there? Because
I did.
I know he did.
What airport were you in?
What airport were you lost? That seems to be the. I don't think we should not allow co-hosts to go to airports.
He's not a co-host. He's a guest commentator, guest panel participant or something.
Yeah,
we haven't given him a full title.
He's a co-host.
He's our chief positivity correspondent. That's what he is. This isn't necessarily, well, it's political, but it's conspiratorial. It's insanity. It's Kurt Russell. You remember Kurt Russell,
who
used to be relevant in Hollywood? You know what he says? Do you know what he said, Stephen? You know the quote I'm about to read?
No, but it's going to make me sad if he ends up being crazy.
He said, one day we will realize that Barack Obama's presidency was the biggest fraud ever perpetrated on America. We will realize that Barack Obama came out of CERN.
What?
Came out of what?
CERN, the laboratory where the Higgs-Boson experimentation
Large Hadron Collider, right?
Yeah.
Like, are these people? I think the first question needs to be asked: does this person have a relationship, like any type of meaningful relationship in their life? If they don't, that should automatically exclude them from the conversation.
Do they have more cats than cars? No, I'm just saying,
cats and, well.
Barack Obama came.
That put me out. I have more cats than cars.
But you're in a relationship.
Nah, not if you ask my wife. we've actually went walking two nights in a row. That's a healthy relationship, isn't
it? Rub it in.
I'm sorry, Steve. I
never go on walks with my wife.
Well, if it helps, maybe this will help. I don't know. Probably not. My brother went walking yesterday morning and fell down, and then I took a fall yesterday.
Oh man!
Damn.
That doesn't make me feel better. Now I feel like you're trying to get in on my wheelchair gig.
Well, that's kind of my concern about you hanging out with Willie in airports is you might lose your wheelchair somehow.
I actually, believe it or not, I'm flying United, and they have
You and Willie are flying United?
No.
Fitzpatrick and Patrick Fitzgerald?
No. No tips. But they have they make it really easy for handicapped people. Like, I was able to call and be like, listen, I need A, B, C, and D, and they're like, cool, print this tag off, we'll take care of everything. So,
well, and to be fair, it's not like you can get up and go in there anyway.
Right.
That's true. It's true. Yeah.
The Theron Hydron, Large Hadron, whatever.
Although I think with the steep decline, I think you could get a good push, you know, going in with, you know, just stick the legs out for it and just ram it with a good,
That's how I used to get in the pool, is I would just go really fast and just hit the edge. Just...
you know what? I haven't played a commercial yet. Are you following that? The baseball thing at all, basketball thing at all?
I went on my bookie to
UConn is the one gonna win all the shit, right? This is
they're the favorite.
Yes, UConn's the favorite, and I had them losing in the semifinals, so my bracket's done.
And Duke got upset over the weekend, so that's a big thing.
That hurt me too.
So that means that my bookie has to change their ad because they have Duke at the final. They have their last image is Blue Devil.
Also, they have that guy doing the travel.
That's big. I can't even, that triggers me so much. I can't even watch that.
The question I have, because UConn is not like, maybe it is now, but when it started all this stuff in basketball, when it got big in basketball, it wasn't like... it wasn't like, you know, a high prestige college. It's never been like you know USC, whatever. You can pick out, you know, the colleges that you. Is it a money thing? How come UConn is in the basketball Sweet 16 every year now? Like, what makes them a basketball, you know, powerhouse?
It's funny if you have like a. Let's say one really good season, that kind of gives you like carte blanche to pick up other players who want to be part of that program. And then, so those good players add to it and add to it. And so it becomes like a self-perpetuating thing, you know, where you have the winning record, a good coach who knows how to recruit, you know, and people want to mm-hmm. be part of a winning thing. If you're like a lower tier team, your pitch has to be, you can be what makes the difference in this team. You can be the star and bring us over the hill. If you go to UConn, you're just going to be like one of 1,000 stars. You may not even get noticed.
Right.
You know, here you can make a difference. You could be the thing that would get us from being the 65th seed to the 32nd seed or something like that.
So there's no spillover, like, because from one sport to another. So if your basketball program is kicking ass for the last, it seemed like the last 20 years or so, UConn has been like always in it. Always
between the men and the women, because the women was also kicking ass as well.
But there's no spillover mm-hmm. to like football. You never hear about UConn's football team.
Not often, no.
Right. Yeah.
Well, everybody knows Huskies are terrible playing football. Why would you?
Huh? Everybody has what?
Everybody knows that they're terrible at football. Why would they go there?
Well, that's what I'm wanting. Because once you get money, it's all about athletic programs get money. Athletic directors get money. Then they can shore up other, you know, other teams within that. You know, but that's how, I don't know, Ohio State, UCLA, USC, well, you know, Penn State, you know.
But it's very seldom that like a school can like dominate all the sports. I'm trying to think, like Alabama is like really, really good. Well, they're good at basketball, but they're really good at football.
Right.
At least they were up until, we'll see what happens next.
Well, USC was big in both. UCLA was big in both. Now I'm going back a long time.
But it doesn't translate to volleyball because some schools just don't focus on the other sports, or the myth is that they can't do that. You know,
right.
It's like, 'cause sometimes you have to overcome the myth as well.
So UConn is going to be in it forever now? Like they'll always be forever and ever and ever? Or will?
No, somebody will come knock them off. But it's going to be hard. It's not going to be easy.
Yeah.
All right. Let's play the commercial again.
The experts at MyBookie have created the ultimate NCAA March Madness betting guide to help you make the best bets throughout the tournament. Throughout this betting guide,
it's April,
the pros
by the way.
Will go
in-depth
on the best
Madness.
Teams, players, and no, bets throughout April, the Madness. Entire NCAA March Madness tournament. 2024 March Madness 85th edition of the NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Tournament tips off Tuesday, March 19th to Monday, April 8th, 2024. Go to mybookie.com/minddog and get up to $1,000 welcome bonus.
Okay, now, we've established now that, look, Ron Kane has disappeared.
There he is.
April 8th is the final day of April Madness. There will be a solar eclipse, a full solar eclipse on April 8th. Since the other day when I went to pick up my wife at the airport, there are the electronic signs are saying solar eclipse on April 8th. Make sure you take mass transit. Why?
I guess they don't want you staring into the sun while you're driving. I don't know.
I don't know. I think this eclipse, like the lead up to it, feels different. And I think a lot of it is from like the news.
That's where I'm going with this because.
Yeah. Okay. Go ahead. Sorry.
No, because there have been solar eclipses my whole life. And I've mm-hmm. never seen a panic about it, like an Armageddon level mm-hmm. event that people are talking about. But even so, a solar eclipse, mass transit, how is that any safer than driving in your own car with putting your headlights on?
Not to sound like Alex Jones, but maybe it's a population control thing.
Wait, could you say it like Alex Jones?
It's population control. They want to put everybody in mass transit, and they're going to use an EMP, and they're going to drop us out of the sky, and we're going to crash buses.
We actually have the real Alex Jones here. If you're listening on the radio side, you probably can't see, but we have the real Alex Jones here with us right now. We also have Robert F. Kennedy Jr. just stopped in to make a few comments on his campaign too. So we, you know, stay tuned. You never know. They're free to chime in whenever they want.
Hey, RFK, where'd the magic bullet go for your brother?
Wouldn't you like to know? I don't fucking know. I've been hitting this joint this morning, laced with creatine and testosterone.
Did he have
they're
a
pretzel? Turning the kids gay with weed.
all kids are gay, and it's okay because they don't get shots, and so they'll die.
We got to get Alex to do some research into the pretzel, the big pretzel.
Research? Conspiracy. Alex, yeah. Do research.
Yeah.
You mean watch YouTube videos until I know all the words right.
You mean you need Alex to pull shit up, pull something out of his ass?
I mean to watch Ron Kane's video. That's what I mean by research.
Okay.
That's on YouTube now, so he could find that and then comment on it. I don't know if there's frog penises in pretzels, but it could be.
Yeah, please comment. I'd love to hear the feedback if you signed.
Now, you're probably going to get age restricted on your YouTube channel for that video, but, you know, it's just that they only do it on one video at a time. They can't do that. Well, maybe they can. This is where it gets tricky for live streams because they don't know what the content is for live streams until after the fact. So to put an age restriction on it, you know, like as a, I don't know, a precautionary measure, that's a little far.
All of my stuff is age protected.
What do you mean, all of your stuff?
Like my YouTube channel. Oh,
YouTube channel.
My YouTube channel and my junk.
Your junk is age protected. It's got an age restriction on it. mine does too, thank God.
Yes.
I have a question for you, Matt, that my wife asked me yesterday. Uh-oh. Yeah, there is a video that I did not post.
18 inches.
It involves... Dolly Parton and the Reverend.
Yeah.
And it's not certain. We didn't create it and we saw it. And so I said, well, maybe Matt created it using AI.
Not using AI. I just went and I just snipped that little piece out of it and shared it.
Okay. That's what I told her. I said, it was probably Matt. She goes, does Matt have access to your accounts? I said, what are you talking about? She goes, it's on your posts right on your page. I said, well, he's a follower, so you can probably just do it.
It's on StreamYard. Everything goes to the StreamYard library, and then you can just export it from StreamYard. You don't have to go to YouTube or any of that kind of stuff.
Well, that's what I told her. That I told her. So once we do it on StreamYard, you have access to that library.
Yeah.
She was like, I don't understand. And I think she was a little bit concerned because of the other AI thing. She was not a fan of that one about why GD is so unpopular.
That is probably the best thing that ever happened to your career.
No, believe me, it won't be.
it absolutely will be because it's gotten some views and people get to know the name, and then they don't. There's no such thing as bad publicity. It's all good publicity. The thing about Mind Dog that is out there, you know, it's pretty fucking makes me look like a pretty retarded guy, but I'm fine with it because as long as people hear the name, the repetitive of the name, then they think, oh yeah, I know that. That people talk, you know, they want to know more. They want to know more. I think
if it used my image or something about me actually other than my name. No, because right now they don't know if I'm a Japanese woman, a white man. Well, they don't know.
Same thing with the Mind Dog thing. They got a guy in a dog mask.
I have a soda commercial that I made with this AI tool, and I threw it in my editor. So I got a couple things to finish up, but then I'm going to drop that today.
What commercial?
I made it's a commercial. It's a soda commercial for the name of the soda is called Dilemma.
I dig it.
Now it went out and tell you I can't find anything on this brand or nothing like that? It just made shit up.
Yeah, it made shit up. Yeah.
But coming back to my original point here this morning with the medical stuff, because AI cannot discern between reality and, you know, just shit that's on the internet. It's right. Like my wife.
I was gonna say it's like a child. It's like a child being raised. If you raise a child with Easter Bunny is real. If you raise a child with the Tooth Fairy is real. It doesn't know any better. It only knows what you tell it.
Right.
You know, you can raise a child and tell him his name is, you know, Bo Diddley, and that's not, it has nowhere on his birth certificate, and he'll grow up answering to Bo Diddley until he's like grown and old enough to find out that his real birth certificate says he's, you know, Ron Kane Jr.
Well, on Facebook the other day, my wife shared a post of McDonald's Baphomet Happy Meal. And I was like, this isn't real. She said, how do you know? And I went to fact check it. And, you know, I Googled McDonald's Baphomet Happy Meal. And there were TikTok videos about it and all this stuff. But I couldn't find any credible news source talking about it at all. But I did find lots of conspiracy theories about the origin, the Kroc brothers who founded McDonald's being Satanists. Like Satanist stuff within the McDonald's brand forever and ever. But she's sharing that stuff, you know, and they had, it was a really good AI creation of it. But without really, you know, doing a deep dive on it. And that's what AI is. Once it puts it out there, it's there for other AI to find it. Again, maybe it's not that serious for internet stuff, because anybody who gets fooled by what they see on Facebook, Twitter, or any of that stuff without doing fact check, that's on them. But when it comes down to medical procedures and you're trusting AI to come up with a cure for cancer or whatever, it could come up with some really sick shit. And then before you know it, you know what? My lung cancer is feeling a little better, but all of a sudden I'm growing a dick out of my forehead. Kind of nightmare scenario or something. It's a sci-fi horror film. Wait,
hey, speak for yourself about having a dick out of your forehead.
Well,
I've seen it come in handy at parties.
Put a suction cup on there, it will.
Yeah.
It's a dick over. You just use it as a
like a come over.
Yeah.
Come over.
So, I mean, she's being touted as an AI expert, but you would think an AI expert would understand that it's not there yet, that the technology can't discern between real and, you know, just data that was dumped into a...
Forget the technology, the person on the campaign can't distinguish between real and unreal. Robert Kennedy Jr. can't distinguish between real and unreal. Forget the technology.
That's true. I don't know. Clint Eastwood is trending, but he's not dead. It doesn't look like he's dead. Clint Eastwood didn't die, did he?
If he did, it's news to me. He's working on another movie. He can't die right in the middle of a movie.
Whenever they start trending shit, I always think somebody, especially when it's an older actor like that.
Isn't he working on like another Dirty Harry movie? Like the dirtiest of Harrys?
He is working on another movie, right? Not Dirty Harry. So.
The dirtiest of Harrys or something.
Old man Harry.
Yeah.
He solves cases in retirement homes, I guess.
the trouble with Dirty Harry, I think is what it's called.
Who's spreading all this VD in this retirement community?
And it's his adventure to go to Mexico to get Viagra because he can't afford it in the U.S.
Oh.
And then he can have a threesome with 2 90-year-olds.
Tarantino is also trending. Is he making a movie? I thought he was done making.
He's working on his last movie, right? His 10th movie, because he said he wanted to do 10 movies and that's it.
So he's done, or is he making one more? Who's that?
No, whatever one he's working on now is the 10th and final movie.
Okay, it doesn't say anything about him making a movie, but he's not dead either. They shouldn't trend people unless they're dead. That's my new thing.
Or they're comedians, because some of us would like to trend without dying. I would love to trend without dying.
Are you sure?
I would like to trend without dying and without my wife leaving me. So, yeah.
Well, obviously she knows about your Dolly Parton blow-up doll there, and she hasn't left you yet.
Well, she, you know, she also understands what it's for. She understands that that doll has never, it's like I said, it's a tax deduction, so I'll never touch it.
Getting a call now from Lincoln, Alabama. Should I answer the call?
Let's do it. I'm from I can talk like this if you want me to. We can get them on the line real quick and find out what they're wanting to talk about.
Hello, Lincoln, Alabama. You're on the air with Coffee with the Dog. Who's calling? Hello? Lincoln, Alabama, you there?
Hello, Lincoln, Alabama.
They hung up. I guess
it's the FBI trying to track your location.
The answer with the Larry King voice. With something. You have to do a Larry King voice who says, "Hello, Lincoln, Alabama."
Thank you.
What's weird is Matt desperately wants to be trending. Willie, he got the wrong cord
at the wrong airport. God damn it!
You got the wrong cord at the. You know what? I played a lot of wrong chords, but I never got the wrong cord. Matt desperately wants to be trending. Desperately.
What's the worst mistake you've ever made while playing in a show? Like music wise, like you ever do the wrong song, the wrong chords, or the no?
Oh, wrong song. I played that. I don't know. Worst. There's no worst.
There's no worst.
No. Well, if I'm going to say the worst, the very first time I was on a big show in a theater-type situation, I did not know about direct boxes. I had a bass plugged in. When we did the sound check, I plugged directly into my amp. When I came back, when we first took the stage, I was like, what's this box? Somebody put this stupid box in between my amp and guitar. So I just took the box and unplugged it and plugged right back into the amp. And then the sound man came running up to the stage. I was like blowing his speakers. So I don't know. That probably the worst. But no, I've started because once I gave up the calling songs to Mikey, he calls songs out. Now, first of all, he doesn't remember titles right. And he will say shit that is just fucking bizarre.
So he may yell out, play Lady in the Tramp, and he actually meant Lady by...
That would be putting it mildly. Like, Jim Croce songs that he sings that one is Bad Bad Leroy Brown, the other is Don't Mess Around with Jim. And they'll say, Jim Brown. Like, okay. Jim Brown.
Then you gotta throw a woman through a plate glass window.
Yeah, he's just all over the place with titles. But there are other times where I just don't hear right, and I didn't hear what he says, and then I'll start a song that he's looking at me like that's not it, that's it. And it's a completely different song. That happens all the time. We adjust. I don't know. Worst that happened, you know. Blowing up a speaker system would be the worst type of. Where were we? I forgot where we were. Where were we? Oh, Willie and desperately wanting to be trending. I don't know. I would like to be trending for the right reasons, within the right community. Let's put it that way. Because I don't want to be famous. I would like the show to be known so that the people who want to use this show as a vehicle to further their career would. But personally, I don't want to be trending. No, not me. Because I think it's always a bad thing. Whenever anybody's trending, it's for like Kathy Griffin. Why was she trending? Because she held up a fucking. Head of Donald Trump, a severed head. I don't want to be known for anything negative.
Lorraine Bobbitt, she was trending because she held up a severed head. Actually, she threw a severed head out into the street.
No, I don't want to be trending for being dead. I mean, nobody will care if I'm dead. I'd care.
Only because I want to know if I'm in your will, can I have your guitars? That's about it.
I'm just a stand-up guy, and I just want to make sure that you're remembered.
Remembered.
Well, in order to help you, I made a little video for you, Matt, to help Mind Dog TV the truth about you, since you were talking about starting a family. So what I'd like to play it.
Yeah, play it. You be my guest. Play.
Yes.
Play.
All
right.
I won't curious to see what it came up with this time.
Yeah, it's interesting.
While we are waiting, people on the radio side, Stephen, the sitcom Ortiz just went black. And you know,
I'm here.
Once you go black, you never come back.
That's not true. The U.S. did it.
I don't see it loading. Oh, here it is. Add to stage.
All right.
In the quaint corners of a small town, there once lay a spark of extraordinary ambition, a desire to challenge the ordinary. Amidst the humdrum of everyday life, a man named Matt Napo decided to turn the world as we know it upside down. Amidst the sun became hidden behind the moon, and the townsfolk gathered around in awe. A peculiar institution was born. Mind Dog, the 11-finger institution. Born out of Matt's love for the peculiar and his fascination with deep state technology, this institution aimed to explore the uncharted territories of science and the supernatural. With a goal that was unique as its name, the institution was committed to creating a family, but not your typical family. This was to be a family of mutant animals, each with their own unique abilities and characteristics. Fast forward to almost a decade later, and the institution stands tall and proud with 43 mutated children. Each child, a testament to Matt's relentless pursuit of his unique vision. Amidst the picturesque mountains of Long Island, New York, the institution is a beacon of the extraordinary amidst the ordinary. Matt's journey was not without its own set of challenges. There were the occasional escaped mutated children causing chaos and confusion. There were the curious townsfolk, always watching, always questioning. But Matt, with his unwavering determination and his love for his unique family, persevered through it all. Each of his 43 children, a story of resilience and innovation. 43? A testament to Matt's unwavering belief in his vision. Each child, a unique masterpiece created with love, passion, and a hint of the extraordinary. Today, as we look back on Matt's journey, we see an extraordinary tale of ambition and determination. We see a man who dared to challenge the norm, to create something truly unique. We see a family that is as extraordinary as its creator. Mind Dog, the 11-finger institution, stands today as a beacon of innovation and ambition. It serves as a reminder that the extraordinary often lies within the ordinary, waiting to be discovered. It stands as a testament to one man's vision, his love for the peculiar, and his relentless pursuit of the extraordinary. So here's to Matt Napo,
the man
who dared to dream differently. Here's to his unique family of 43 mutated children. And here's to Mind Dog, the 11-finger institution, a beacon of the extraordinary amidst the ordinary. In the end, it all comes down to one man's vision.
Taking a shit on stage? What the fuck?
Of the extraordinary. And that, I'm sorry, friends, for the people on the something to celebrate.
Audio only side. That was incredible. There was no talk about pretzels in any of that. I do have a link in the description now. The link is in the description. It's scrolling on the bottom for in video. Go to that link. And you can get this toy and create all sorts of conspiracy theories about me or anybody else on the program, or about your friends or what. It's very weird. Do you know how much of the prompt did you put 43 children in there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I wrote some of that script. I was hoping I put in there to have like the townspeople with pitchforks and torches outside of a gate, but it didn't come up with that.
There
we go. It gives you an option to add to your prompt to edit the video and change something, right? Yeah. Did you get that?
Yeah. I've been playing with it and trying different things. So,
I do not care about your sex life. Now, Ron is using the free version, but you can get the free version. You can sign up for free. What Ron just did was the free version. The only issue with the free version, as you might have noticed in that one, is it leaves watermarks on it for stock video. But other than that, you can use it for just about anything. And for the you can sign up for the plus, where you get rid of all the watermarks and all that kind of stuff. if you are so inclined. But so InVideo, our new sponsor, there's a link on the homepage, a banner on the homepage where you can check it out. I think this product is going to, it's not just fun and silly. There are some legitimate uses for it, for marketing, for training videos, for things like that. You can actually use it to do some really good stuff.
So it's just that link?
Yes.
Okay.
There's a link in the actual chat room. I will put the link in the description too when we're off the air. But
so
yeah.
Where is it stored? Is it stored on your device or in the cloud or wherever you want it stored?
It's stored in the cloud, but then you can download it and you can re-edit some of this stuff.
So. Yeah, that's what I'm doing with that soda commercial that I made because of some of the stock footage you gave me. So I've been going in through there and editing it down and adding different things.
Yeah. Now you can tell it to do it with captions or without. One of the complaints I got last night from, it was the Tosh video on YouTube. So somebody complained about why does every YouTube video I see now have these forced captions? It's annoying and distracting, and I don't like it. Well, he said, does it help with the monetization at all? Yes, it helps with the monetization at all. I'm going to have to answer this question. YouTube likes it when you have the monetization or when you have the captions in there, colorful, like the Mr. Beast type of stuff where they're popping up and all that stuff. They like it because if you don't have your sound on, those captions might entice somebody to actually play the clip. And when you're just seeing the thumbnail go by for the teaser, it might actually entice people to play it. And YouTube will push it more if you have those in there because they think that that's a good incentive for people to actually watch the video.
Yeah.
So, yes, it does help your monetization. You're going to get more views, and YouTube will push it more. So that's the reason everybody's doing it. Now, I understand that some people find it annoying, especially if, let's just say, there's a hot chick and the captions come up right in front of her tits when you're trying to see her tits. That could be a real, you know, I'm trying to look at her tits, and I can't see her tits.
Well, that's when you just use a bunch of words with O's in it. That way you can see right through the middle of the O. It's fine.
Well, like on YouTube, they tell you there's a huge percentage of people that just watch videos without the sound most
right.
of the time. And that's why they want you to have captions. And
absolutely. Now, they have captions that they can, auto captions that you can turn on and off.
Yeah.
But it's not the same. That's a little type text across the bottom. Sometimes that gets lost. But yeah, I understand. But here's the thing that bought, because I got this in the middle of the night. And it affected my ability to get back to sleep. Because now, why are you complaining to me about this? If this is a trend on YouTube and everybody's doing it, you said it started out with, why is every video I see on YouTube now have this? Why am I the guy you're complaining to if you're seeing it on every video?
Because you're the one who started it. You started the trend. If you had not done the first
I'm
video.
I'm not a trendsetter, my friend.
If you had not done the first video doing that.
I'm a trend follower.
Else, everyone else copying your style.
Matt is a part of the deep state. That's why he knows.
He's been planted by the CIA because all he wants to do is turn the kids gay.
That's true. People have call me a dark state operative. Dark operative. What the fuck does that
a
even
dog
mean?
Dog operative? Hell yeah.
Yeah.
That's because your ancestry is from the south of, or north, or east, or west of Italy. Wherever the olive skin people are.
Wherever the olive skin people are.
That sounds like a brand of porn, the dark state.
Let's see here. Desktop. Mysterious. Here we go.
Bring the enigmatic figure known as Mind Dog. Who is this man of many talents, and what lies beneath the surface of his public persona? Some say Mind Dog is a comedic genius, able to make audiences roar with laughter at his witty jokes and sharp observations.
Hasn't happened here yet today.
His quick wit and charm have captivated many.
Charm?
But is there more to him than meets the eye? Others believe Mind Dog is a rock star in disguise. With a voice that can move mountains and a stage presence that electrifies crowds. His music speaks to the soul. But could there be a hidden agenda behind his melodic tunes?
Absolutely.
And then there are those who speculate that Mind Dog is not just an entertainer, but a covert operative working in the shadows. Mysterious demeanor and uncanny ability to navigate any situation suggest a darker, more secretive side to his persona, uncovering the truth behind the rumors and speculation. Is he truly a comedian, a rock star, or a secret agent? The answers may surprise you.
No, the answers are no. That's the none of the above. But yeah, so I mean, all I said was make me a short about Mind Dog.
So this link right here,
yes,
is not working.
And you got to put did you put HTTPS in front of it?
Oh no, I didn't do that.
Yeah, you just can't type that in.
Yeah, you just can't do that, Steven. Get with it.
Steven. No wonder you're in the hospital.
What?
No, I think you can just put that in there.
Hold on. No wonder you're in the hospital, Steven.
Do I need to correct my link? Is that the problem?
Okay, I tried it with the HTTP and it's not working.
All right. So. I'm seeing if I can fix it. Hold on. Maybe you discovered a problem in the linkage world of linkage.
Well, I've been having a hard time finding a site to just have art and videos generated. I've been looking for one, and this is so exciting for me because I'm going to make the stupidest things.
All right, give me a second. I gotta.
That's what the technology is for, isn't it?
Yeah, man. Like, listen, castigate redendo mores. It's one of my favorite Latin phrases, and it means to laugh and make light of customs and situations. I live by it. If I can make a dick joke out of it, I love it.
We should. Everyone out there should start giving money and donations to the Matt Napo 11 Finger Institute.
Uh-oh.
So we can keep creating kids.
I don't know who this Napo guy is, but I don't
like. Yeah, Mike Napo is supposed to.
I don't like him. I don't like him. I don't like him at all.
I think once you got to know him, you might like him.
I don't know.
I mean, we don't. We know him.
Now, Matt Napo, if that's how you pronounce his last name.
That is correct.
He's a cool dude.
Really?
I think
he's cool. Have you met him?
Not in person, but kind of.
Yeah. First of all, he's about 4'2" in person. He sits like on 3 phone books in the studio.
That's true. I'm very short. Time is short, and so is Joe Rogan.
I'm also short. I'm only 5'5".
Here's the link. Now, this link looks good, man. It works. It works for me. Let me just...
Oh, you know what it is, Steven? Did you use the handicap accessible option on your when you did the link?
Nope, it was blacked out. Thanks, GD.
Okay. Try that. Try using handicap
accessible. Banners. Let me just change this banner here a little bit.
I'm sorry. Ableist accessible. I don't know how this. Look, I don't know the right terms because I honestly have difficulty caring about the right terms.
Can you see the one in the chat room and click on it and see if that works?
Yeah, this one. Which chat room?
All of them. I think YouTube, Facebook.
I was looking at the chat room in StreamYard. Give me a second.
I could put it in the private chat too. Private chat. Here you go.
Hey.
Private chat to put it in.
Hey, there we go.
And make sure you use the one with money so you can get rid of the watermarks. Yep.
That works.
That works. Okay, so that's the one you go to. Whatever. I just posted it to Facebook and Twitter and all that stuff. But yeah, so it's free to sign up in video. They're a new sponsor. I hope you try them out. And it's good to have a product that people actually want to use. I think this is a good one.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm going to make the dumbest things with this. I'm so excited.
I'm glad you're excited. We could be careful because it will lie to you.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
I mean, maybe, you know what, just to make GD's wife happy, or if he really has a wife, well, I'll do
I
one.
I have there. A real wife. I have a wife.
Right. Settle down there, little girl.
It annoys me that you can't. I have a wife. Here's a picture.
Right. Pictures don't do it. Tim Scott, you got to, even beyond the Tim Scott thing, you have to take her out, bring her on camera, and make out with her on camera, and then we'll kind of accept that as proof.
Well, that's definitely not my wife. That'd get me in trouble.
Where was that going?
The weirdest thing is, people still send me ass pics and breast pics. Like, I'm not even asking for them.
I would not want that.
Somebody, I don't like it.
Yeah, no, I don't like it either. We have to say goodbye to Govs. I forgot we have to say goodbye to Govs.
Bye, Govs.
Bye, Govs.
Yeah, what's going on, Govs? You know what? Get David Tell back there. Get Louis C.K. in there. Get Steven, the sitcom Ortiz in there. Get somebody that I want to see. Somebody posted, I forget who it was, on Twitter the other day about, Charles Ferguson, I think it was, about people who, maybe Will Bridges, somebody I know, they were posting that it's okay if you want to send me titty pictures or, you know, pussy pictures or whatever, unsolicited. No, not that I mind looking at naked women. I think if I got one of those on my phone, a text from that, my wife would find it and she would be like, assuming that I solicited it and wanted it. So no, I would block somebody. If somebody did that to me, I would delete it immediately and then block that person, no matter who they are. I don't want.
Yeah.
I did
the same thing. Cause my wife, she trusts me 100%. Right. In fact, every time it happens, I tell her and she laughs. But I know that at some point I'm going to get a pic, and I'm not going to be by my phone. She's going to be like, "Oh, I got it, honey," and it's going to cause chaos.
Right.
So what's going to happen?
Okay. If I didn't have a wife, would I have a Scrabble board where I play Scrabble with my cat? No.
We don't.
No. If you were the guy lying about having a wife, you'd play Scrabble with your cat.
Hey, no, only if I didn't have a wife, would I have this?
See. Yeah.
Well, that's why I only send tasteful nudes out to everybody.
Right. Yeah, I like to do what's called smush pics.
Yeah. Well, the more desperate you are to try to prove to us that you have a wife, the more we doubt it. That's all. I'm just putting that out there.
No, I'm not desperate. I just want people to understand it.
I know. We've overused the word desperate here today. I'm desperate to be trending. Desperately want to be.
Yeah, you're desperate to be trending.
When you have a face this good looking, okay? Women need to understand that I am not on the market. Otherwise, this show will be like inundated with women who want to hook up with me. And that's why I have to keep reminding them so I can keep them at bay. Otherwise, we'd have like 400,000 women watching us trying to hook up with me.
All right,
so I have to let them know
I'm half off, so women always love me.
Like a sail, like a shoe.
Yeah.
Like a shoe shell.
Yeah, it's 100%. Like it was like the Michael Jackson sale at the old local department store. Boys' pants half off.
I heard his last song that he wrote before he died was in A minor.
Why? Because it's getting to be really disturbing, the amount of no shows that, because we were on a roll there without the no shows for quite a long time, but lately it's just getting out of control. This woman who was going to be on the show today, Lady Nicole out of Washington D.C., was very excited about being on. It was like nine. Oh, Lincoln, Alabama, you're calling again.
Hello, Lincoln, Alabama.
Probably just another delivery coming to
Alabama, you're on with Coffee and the Dog. You're going to talk again this time, or are you going to hang up on me? Hang up.
Hi, I just found this young man named Willie walking through the airport. He says he belongs to you.
Very strange that I keep getting these calls from Lincoln, Alabama. But the trend with people who are excited about being on the show, they correspond. Like, she wrote to me at 11 o'clock last night. Got it. Looking forward to it. Thank you.
That's so weird.
Just oversleep. People, I can't get up. I can't get up, man. It's too early for me. It's not a time zone issue. She's in Washington, D.C.
It's not a time zone. It's a Chocolate City issue.
Do you have maybe a way to either set like schedule a message to go out or somebody to message these people in the mornings to verify they're still coming?
I do. I always morning before the show, I will send them the link and tell resend the link from that they got.
Super odd.
Just very weird. Like why so? And the genius guy never even responded at all. Like what happened to you? But his website's still up. I was going to say, I think maybe he was in over his head and trying to get publicity for his product and then decided, you know what, it's not ready for prime time yet. That's why he fired his publicist or whatever, or quit his publicist, whatever that happened. But that might explain one, but not like 8 or 10 in the last 2 weeks. It's just very weird. I mean,
yeah, it seems
even
really
weird for me. So just to let people know who might be on, Red Hot Llama is scheduled for tomorrow. Red Hot Llama is
like on every fucking show. I've seen Red Hot Llama on like 9 or 10 different shows this week. It's like everywhere, every fucking.
Tell me a little bit about them.
I don't know. I just said that. I have no idea who Red Hot Llama
is. Is it a person or persons?
Sounds like a candy, doesn't it? Red Hot Llama.
Yeah.
Sounds like a really bad stripper name.
Red Hot Llama, Liar Side of Finance. It's a Liverpool comedian talking about embarrassing mothers dating menopausal women, kebabs, and mice. A comedian from Liverpool calling himself Red Hot Llama. Okay. So he's supposed to be the first guest tomorrow, and then James Cloud, who is an author, will be the second guest. Now, James,
he'll show up, but it'll be around dinner time, right around scone time.
Possibly. I just want to see James Cloud's story again one more time. I'm excited about this law enforcement guy. I don't think that's him. No, that ain't him. Can you go? James Cloud, a retired educator with more than 30 years experience in teaching history, government, U.S. citizenship preparation, German and English as a second language, born in New Mexico shortly before the outbreak of World War II. As a child, he heard a lot about war and the treatment of Jewish people in Europe. It created a curiosity. So we're going to talk a little bit about Brandenburg. His book is Brandenburg, a Story of Berlin. It's going to be about, World War II and the Nazis. So I'm always interested in that stuff. We'll find out if they had any pretzels.
Now, this show here, once it gets archived, can you change the name of the show? Because right now, I think the name of the show is Comedian Living Nicole. Can you change it to, let's say, No Show Nicole or something like that?
I will put that in the description generally when I put it onto Spotify. Because after the show is live on YouTube, I need to publish it to Spotify. So I generally do that. And whenever they're a no-show, I put so-and-so was a no-show, don't know what happened, but I still leave that link in there. Need a good manager to sort them out for no-shows. Mary, you want to take this on? You want to be part of the show? I definitely need some help business-wise in running this stuff. And right now, it's nice. Running at just cost. But if somebody comes on and dedicates themselves to being part of the team, I will sign whatever kind of long-term contract for a profit sharing when we get to the point where we're actually making a profit. We can come up with an agreement. If you want to help out, I know you.
Well, she offered to be a good manager. She says you need a good manager, not a good manager.
Hey, I'm down to help as well.
See, read the fine print, Matt. She's not offering to manage. She's saying that you need like a shepherd or something or someplace.
No, she wasn't offering her services. I'm just saying.
No, she's not offering her services. She's saying you need a place to keep your wild animals.
She said not ready, but maybe. Wow, how about that? I got a maybe.
Most
women don't give me a maybe, but I usually get a shut down not ever right from the start. So
I mean, you're so busy with those 43 kids. So it's
hey, you know what? If she falls through, I don't work during the day, man. I got you if you need it.
Got you.
All right. Well, I would definitely. Well, let's talk offline about that. Yeah, who was the biblical guy who had 700 wives and 230 or something
Solomon.
Concubines?
Solomon. No. King Solomon.
So he
was
must
it King Solomon?
700 wives.
I think it was 700 concubines. I don't think it was that many wives.
Can you imagine 700 women all synced up on their period at the same time?
That's yeah, because they definitely do, right? They
that would you, he how did yeah, he not get murdered?
Then, back then, a woman on her period was unclean, so she was whisked away until the period stopped.
700 so, of them? No, there's
Solomon had 700 wives and 300 concubines. That comes out to a nice 1,000.
Yeah.
Now concubine. What is the official like job description for a concubine?
Isn't that like a hooker?
I don't know. I'm asking. This concubine's job description. Ron's
well,
doing a video
on
it.
Then than it is now.
Matt Napo's concubines is the next video coming out.
Concubines, a woman who lives with a man but has lower status than his wife or wives.
But she's still sucking him off.
Yeah,
basically, yeah. So it's basically a mistress. Well, so there's two meanings. The archaic meaning is a mistress.
Right.
The historical meaning and it's used in polygamous societies is kind of like the new girlfriend or the new thing plaything of the family that's not a wife yet.
Okay. The reason I brought this up now because Ron has put this out there about my 43 kids that I really wanted to keep quiet. Did Solomon have children with every one of those 700?
I don't think so. Because no. Can you imagine a child support?
It's you know it's a lot to
feed. And not only that, if he had,
or even if it was just one kid per wife, that's a lot of mouths to feed.
And not only that, if there were just say one kid per woman, 1,000 kids. You know by now there would have been descendants of Solomon. You know how the Hebrews kept track of descendants like crazy.
The concubines wouldn't have kids. They were just like.
Why wouldn't they? Especially if you're looking for a male heir. Male heirs were like precious.
Because I thought they were like
and
just
that would
like
increase their status.
Sex workers or something. Not necessarily.
Yeah, but if they could give a male heir, that would increase their status.
They were on the pill, or something. They were, the concubines were they were using prophylactic.
But the reason, and that's also the reason why Solomon built all those temples, so they could have all those stairs, so they can get rid of all the abortion.
In the day, you know, just like with my grandmother had 17 children. So we're assuming one child per 700. I'm just going on based on the 700 wives, not the 300 concubines. Get your concubines out of here. Take your concubines and get out of here. But okay. The 700 wives, if they all had like 10 kids each, they, you know, you're talking, how am I going to feed all these kids? I'm going to have to take a second job.
He wasn't diddling all of them, that he had assistants diddling them on his behalf. Like, you know, I'm really tired tonight. Can you screw my wife for me? And like, okay, boss, you insist.
That is some pretty serious cuck energy, though, I think, with all that, yeah.
Because if you imagine being one of the women waiting your turn to be screwed by the king, you know, I believe there's some exaggeration, you know, or maybe he didn't have them all at one time. Maybe just like one week at a time, just marry, fuck, kill, marry, fuck, kill.
Where would you put all those people?
That's why he was the first one to play the game, marry, fuck, kill.
Well, it's up to you to decide how many bedrooms your house has, right? I mean, anything could be a bedroom.
Any room could be a bedroom.
The kitchen could be a bedroom. So, but 700 is pushing it a little bit.
That's too many. There's no way.
The bathroom is now a bedroom. So anyway, we'll talk about Nazis tomorrow, and maybe we'll have some comedy from Liverpool. Now, it's not morning for the guy in Liverpool.
No.
Mike said I should get the cell number, and I do have, generally have cell numbers for them. And if I do, I do text them as a reminder, but not always.
But now, Matt, you may want to check one thing with him, because unless I'm mistaken, and I'm usually never wrong, but this Sunday, this weekend, their time changed. They added an hour. They sprung forward. And so when you initially made the schedule, they were only 4 hours ahead. Now they're 5 hours ahead. So you may want to just make sure that they got that, because...
Willie says, according to Google, Solomon only had 4 kids. Now, man, that's pretty lame for a guy who's got 700 wives, right? Mary says it's 5 hours. Yeah, I knew it was 5 hours. I mean, we're used to that with Carl. But I should have Carl go over and tighten this guy up. Oh, Carl's in Amsterdam right now. He's not even in England anymore at the moment. He's in Amsterdam, whatever he's doing there. Probably getting some concubines.
Avoiding Interpol.
No, he's buying some concubines to take home. I don't know. Can you take concubines across border? Can you take
there is like a tax. In England, they make you pay a tax on everything you bring across the border.
Now, are they carry-on, or do you have to check them?
No, it's carry-on. But it depends on how big they are. If they're Philippine, you can probably do carry-on. But if they're like Russian, you got to check them in. But like anything you send to England, they have to pay tax on. I mailed a package to a friend of mine there. And when he got the package, he had to pay more in taxes than the package was worth.
You got to pay for that lifestyle, that queen lifestyle.
Yeah.
The healthcare is not going to pay for itself.
Right. It's true.
That's true.
It does not.
We have Jackie Martling on Wednesday. Now, that's a one guest, basically.
For 3 hours. One guest for 3 hours, because it takes him an hour to realize that we're off the air and he can stop talking.
Right. Now, on Thursday, I've gone through this week's schedule already last week, but on Thursday, I have a guy named John Dangerfield, and he wants to talk about Miami, Babylon, Long Island comedy connection. Now, Babylon, Long Island is where Rodney Dangerfield comes on. I tried Googling John Dangerfield. I got nothing. I got nothing. And then Angela Bayer, who is a woman who lifts weight, I don't know, a female bodybuilder health coach, will be our second guest. Those women, you know, with man muscles, they intimidate the fuck out of me.
But some of them are so hot.
Hot?
Some of them are.
Huh?
Rachel McLeish? Come on. Rachel McLeish?
You got man muscles. I ain't into it.
Well, they're woman muscles because they're on a woman.
But they look like man muscles.
No, they're just like muscles. Muscles are just muscles. It depends on. I mean,
women aren't supposed to have biceps.
If a woman had good, strong Kegel muscles, would you like kick her out of bed? No,
I would.
No,
I get.
She'd kick me out of bed because she'd probably be stronger than me. But
I only get weirded out when.
When they look you in the eye, I know. When they kick you in the mouth.
When they can beat you in arm wrestling.
No, well, that would be a neat trick. But it freaks me out, I think, like when the chest turns into pecs.
Yeah.
I think at that point, I'm like, that's a little too buff for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, if they take their shirt off and it looks just like.
All right, what's weirder? What's weirder, a woman who has Schwarzenegger?
I am trying not to listen to your conversation. But...
Oh, don't worry. It's just live in front of thousands.
No, has some expertise in this.
You're welcome.
What is weirder, a woman with like Schwarzenegger-style pecs or an old man who's got gynecomastia, meaning his pecs are starting to turn into tits? Which is more of a weird
it's
thing.
The second one. It's the
well, she left, but I think the second one is definitely the worst one for sure.
Yeah, because the second one is just going to happen. The first one, you have to work at it, and you can stop at any time.
Yeah,
you know, you I'm don't gonna have to see something going. Here.
The first one, you can stop. You don't have to keep going, but with the other one, you can't stop it. It's like gravity and age.
Do you?
No, guy don't come back.
Do any of you watch wrestling?
Not me. No. I had, I can't think of it, David Monster, who is, he's the author of the Rowdy Armstrong books. It's gay wrestling. And I asked him, what's the difference between gay wrestling and regular wrestling? Because it seems like the goal is the same. It's to get the other guy down and, like, rub your junk on his face.
That's fun.
No, one's hotter than the other. I think that's pretty simple.
Maybe agreed.
Maybe gay wrestling, you do it with makeup. Because I remember when I was in high school, I wrestled the wrestling coach for my audition to get on the wrestling team. And he couldn't pin me. So he grabbed me by my testicles. Okay.
Oh.
Yeah. And that was, it was out of anger because like he couldn't pin me. And I kept escaping. So he just grabbed me by my testicles. And I screamed like a little girl. And he told me, next time you'll wear a cup. That was, I'm sorry. That was, but yeah, I did not. I quit the wrestling team like shortly after, as soon as the swelling went down, I quit the wrestling team.
See, the problem for the people on the radio side now and the people on the video side here is that often the other people on the show think I am their therapist and they start to have conversations that are, they should only be having with their therapist. And I think we just saw an example of that. Now, Rowdy, David's comment was that there is no difference between gay wrestling. And he said, listen, if they didn't realize that it was homoerotic, they wouldn't be oiling themselves up like that. And wear, you don't need to wear like those tight fucking nothing else. You could wrestle in like shorts that cover up and don't show you your junk. They do it to be homoerotic on purpose.
They could wear the old NBA shorts like John Stockton.
Right.
And still be just as wrestly.
Yeah. I mean, boxers, you don't see boxers doing, you know, wearing it, you know, basically a wedgie and coming out and showing their asshole and rubbing their junk on the other guy's face when they're down. That's the problem I have with it. So basically, because Stephen asked if you guys watch wrestling, that was my. I've never watched wrestling. I've always thought it brought my homophobia to a extreme level.
Well, listen, I as a kid getting surgeries in the hospital, I used to watch it with my uncle who just died. So it's always had a special place in my heart.
Why are you watching TV with your dead uncle?
Well, he wasn't dead then.
But you said he just died, and you were watching. You said he just died. You was watching with him.
No, he just died 5 minutes ago while watching this program this morning.
Yes.
You heard about the pretzels.
He actually got a hard-on from your blow-up doll, and he had a stroke. Anyway, but the reason I asked was the pictures that I sent you guys. Oh, I sent Ron and Matt. I was in the process of trying to send it to GD. That's where it gets to be gross and too big.
Right.
What?
I'm sending it to you now, GB.
Is this another one of your dick pics? Because I'm still recovering from the last two.
Yeah,
I know.
I just said I'm not.
It's on Facebook Messenger.
Steven sent me dick pics like right next to his spokes in his wheel. It's like you know how like when we were kids, you could put a card in the spokes of your wheel and go boom. He did that with his penis. He stuck his penis in the spokes
let's not let his penis come between us. I just got this message on Rumble. Hey there, I adore your content. It was fantastic and incredibly engaging this morning.
Aw. What? Neat.
Yeah. See that? Now that's what I'm talking about. That kind of
too big.
The stomach muscle, the six-pack abs, the biceps. No, I'm sorry. That's guy stuff for me. I know.
Who does her makeup?
Huh?
Who does her makeup? The eyeshadowing is perfect. Oh, my God. man.
Now, that opened up a whole other Pandora's box about this stuff about men, you know, trans people who were born male on women's sports team, because somebody like that, that's a woman who was born a woman. I think she could compete with men on just about any level. Well,
I agree. There's definitely women that are built a lot like men that could compete, But when you start getting into these sports, like the swimming, for example, the dude's 3 feet taller than every other competitor. He right. outweighs him by 100 pounds, and he probably has three times the muscle mass.
Right.
Okay, well, when we were kids, the best athlete in our neighborhood was a woman named, a girl named Pat. Technically, okay, her name was Pat, but we all called her Fat Pat, and you can pretty much guess why. She whenever we picked teams, her and Andre were not allowed to be on the same teams. They had to be the captains of the two different teams. If you put the two of them on the same team, no matter what sport, they were going to win. You know, so she was the best player we had, the best quarterback, the best running back, the best baseball hitter, pitcher. She was number one. She beat up other guys.
Mm-hmm.
She was just a monster. You know?
Right. Who are we talking about?
A girl in my neighborhood when I was
a girl in his neighborhood.
I was going to say, there's another example, and again, from wrestling, but there was a lady named China.
Yeah,
that's country.
Yeah, she was bigger than 90% of the guys in WWF at the time.
Right. Well, then yeah, I have no doubt that just about any woman in
feminine anyway. They were feminine anyway.
Any woman in MMA would kick my ass at this point.
You can't run?
Huh?
You can't run? Because I'd run.
No, not
that. I've never been seen running from a woman and seeing being have my ass beat by one.
Well, you know, you bring that up. Yesterday there was a video of a guy getting cops chasing this dude on a beach. And as the caption was, what the hell did this guy do that made everybody on the beach want to beat him up? Now, this guy's running, and everybody is trying to get a piece of him, and he's getting away. And they're running down the beach, and this guy's just outrunning everybody. And I'm like, I don't care what he did. Somebody should draft him as a running back because nobody could fucking stop this guy. Everybody was running after him, and he was unstoppable.
Was it Forrest Gump?
I don't know.
He was running.
He was running.
Was it Sean Combs? Was it Puffy Combs? Because if that's the case, you don't have to wonder what he did. You have to wonder what he didn't do.
Forrest Combs.
Oh, here it is. Let me see. It's going to take a second. Well, I know we need to get off the air, but I want to see.
We can take a bet. Bet mybookie.com. I said Sean Combs.
Enter studio.
Can we go to mybookie.com and bet on what country Diddy's going to be caught in?
No. We can't bet on anything at my bookie.
He's got 9 passports, one for each Diddy.
Ew.
Yeah.
Present.
Can't believe Diddy's a diddler.
It's in the name. That's what Diddy is short for.
It is.
This guy, look.
Great.
Now this guy should get. Look how fucking fast he's running. I should bring it back to the beginning.
Well, that's his poor tackle. They caught him 3 times.
Oh, we got drop kicks.
Well, one more time. What did he do that everybody wants a piece of him?
See, that guy just tried to kick him. That's not tackling. That's not tackling.
I wonder if he was fucking around with a kid and they caught him or tried messing with a kid or a woman.
Yeah. Well, it just seemed to me that some football team should be drafting that dude.
No kidding. I mean,
the problem is in football, you're wearing clothes. There are only three places to grab that guy. His shorts, which means he could pop out of them, and then you'd be wrestling with a naked man. The other men don't want that. He escapes it that way.
Then he should be in wrestling.
Right. See, if you put him in football, except football, there's pads, helmets, there's other places to grab him.
Looks like Ron's getting in trouble.
Especially somebody that pale, you know he's got, sunscreen block 400 or something. So he's already slippery. So, that video...
Then he should be in wrestling because it's all gay anyway.
Yeah, if anything, he should be doing that suntan commercial with the dog that grabs the shorts off the ass.
Yeah.
No, maybe.
Now, Hulk Hogan actually got, well, Hulk Hogan, with the help of Peter Thiel, got Gawker Gawker put out of business for printing some stuff about Hulk Hogan's gay.
It was, yeah.
Do you do a Hulk Hogan imitation, Steven? Brother!
Let me tell you what, brother! Brother!
Yeah, let me try. I think I can do one, but I don't.
All right. Come on, brother! Right now, I need you. All you Hulkamaniacs out there, come out here and watch me fuck my wife.
Prove that I'm not gay. Yeah. But it was important enough to him to get this Gawker pretty much put out of business. They sued, I don't know. But yeah. Peter Thiel, who is gay, but did not want the world to know that he was gay.
Didn't he get another company shut down for releasing a sex tape?
Yeah, yeah.
But isn't also Peter Thiel isn't he's rich enough? I mean, he's like a billionaire. So if he doesn't want to be gay anymore, can't he just buy straightness?
No, it's not that he doesn't want to be gay. He didn't want the world knowing he was gay. He was fine with being gay.
Well, I heard injecting money kills AIDS, not the gay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So that's why Patrick Johnson's still alive.
We should get in video to do a video about Peter Thiel so we could get shut down. And that's the show for today. April Fools. You guys got anything else to add? Steven's got a big show tonight. Once they let him out of jail here.
I have the April Fools show tonight in South Bend. And then this Saturday I'll be in Leesburg.
And Mr. Tongues tonight in Harrisburg.
Yeah.
Then tomorrow night at the Doghouse.
Yep.
An appearance at John Hopkins Hospital at 1:30 today.
What city are you in?
I'm in the Harrisburg, Pennsylvania area. And today is, also want to give a shout out because today is the national holiday. It's my wife's birthday as well. I know it's
Steve. Also my wife's birthday. I was just about to say, I wanted to say happy birthday to my wife also. Legitimately, her birthday is today as well.
So basically, none of the three of you really have wives. This is all an April Fool's thing.
I was about to say happy birthday to my wife as well.
Oh, God. Here's my wife.
She's been that's the same picture I use.
Here's my wife.
It's the same picture Ron uses.
Ooh, his wife's black. Oh, now she's not.
Oh, look at Siri.
That's your wife.
I'm married to Siri, yeah.
I think it's funny. I say I'm going to the hospital at 1:30 today, and nobody gives a shit. Steven goes to the hospital, and it's like a day of mourning.
Well, what do you
All right, PD, stop making it about yourself.
Really? What are you having done now? Colonoscopy or just a follow up? Results? What are you doing?
Prostate massage.
It's a consult. They found a hereditary anomaly.
Anomaly?
Yeah.
They got them all fast last time.
Hereditary?
Yeah. A hereditary anomaly. So I have to go on for a consult with the gynecologist. Yeah.
Going in for that prostate massage.
See, this is the problem. You got to stop going to doctors.
Sorry, this is I can't stop going because it's like the only friends I have now.
Well,
the only friends I have are the doctors.
They're once you start going, they just want you to keep coming back just to keep billing the insurance companies.
I'm fine with that.
You're fine with that?
Yeah.
You wouldn't rather just use the time constructively? Listen, my mother.
They're the only friends I have. They're the only people that will talk to me. Nobody else will talk to me.
My brother has been dying for 40 years, and he's still with us. It's never going
to
happen.
To be fair, because we're all born going to dying.
Well, no, we're not all born dying. We don't start dying until the body, until the cells die more than they reborn, recreate.
The point I was making is if my brother stopped going to doctors and he stopped dying. 40 years ago, they told him you got like six months to live.
Jeez.
He stopped going and he's still living. Stop going to doctors. Just quit.
But I'm not dying per se. I'm just going to the doctors because
they will tell you you're dying.
I don't have any friends. That's why I'm going.
Doctors make shitty friends.
What are you talking about? They make the best friends because they have to listen to you.
Steven, how's your doctor treating you?
My doctor's been cool.
Oh, I thought you said you didn't even meet. I thought you said he never came in to see you. Like
the
you.
Last, the when I was admitted and let go the first time, no, not at
this
all.
This is the guy who wanted to cut your foot off.
Yeah, this new doctor this time was cool. He was nice.
Wow.
All right.
I would like to amend my statement. And just keep going to doctors, and don't do anything but go to doctors. That's my new. I've completely done a flip flop on this. Just always go to doctors. Go to all doctors all day, all the time. Okay, are we cool?
Cool.
All right. Yeah. All right. So let's end it there. April Fool's on all of you guys. We'll talk about Ron's soul drills next time. If he's on tomorrow, that will be fine, or Wednesday, or whenever you're back on. Well, I want to find out about how soul drills went, and I'm assuming that was a fun room.
You won't find out on Wednesday, Ron, because you won't get a chance to talk on Wednesday.
Yeah.
No, actually, Jack, you probably would love to talk about
soul drills. He'll talk about soul drills. Yeah, he will, because he was just there like a month or two ago.
Right, and he's going to be there again next week or something, so. Yeah, he would definitely want to talk about that. Anyway, that's the show for today. I'm kicking you guys out. Are you comfortable with that?
Let's go.
All right, April Fool's.
Does it matter?
No, it doesn't matter. April Fool's on all of you. I'm sorry about Lady Nicole not showing up. I will try to get to the bottom of that. I will take your advice on sending text messages and phone calls and all that stuff. So, you know what? Go to mybookie.com and bet on whether Red Hot Llama or James Cloud will be here tomorrow. And that's all I got to say about that. So, thanks for coming. And don't forget to turn on your radio. Thanks.
Matt, I didn't get to do my coffee thing today.
I'll do it twice tomorrow.
Okay, I'll do it twice
tomorrow. Well, you might not be alive tomorrow because you're going to a doctor and they're probably going to go ahead, do it now.
Okay. MindDog.com. MindDogTV.com, the only place to go to get real medical advice. MindDogTV.com.
The medical advice being don't go to the doctor, but go to the doctor all the time. Don't go to the doctor, but go to the doctor just every second of every day. All right. Thanks for coming. Don't forget to turn on your radio. Bye for now.
me, listen to me, listen to me now. Listen to me, listen to me, listen to me now. Listen to me, listen to me, listen to me now. Listen to me, listen to me, listen to me now.